Hit it to the white dot, Joe.
White dot?
White dot. Right, you still move your feet up. What school are you at?
Homeschool.
Yeah, don't you play for a school though?
I don't play at.
Why not? What? High school. You know, he's high school, he's 15, so he can play for high school, right?
Texas Tech, UNC, Duke, they're all saddling up. So you guys need to look at the diagram because all the top schools are using that method, right? It's right here, saddling up. It's not back here. It's right here. And we're going to get your stance that you need with a short measuring bat. A lot of people don't understand what this bat is for. It's for you to get the distance where you can get the outside pitch and turn on the inside pitch, and then when you get this is how close you'll be. So I was talking to you guys about the short bat. So when people see the short bat, there's a little black one this big. That's your one-hand bat. This is a short two-hand bat, okay? Remember I talked to you guys about saddling up? You watch college games, not so much the pros, but you watch college games, they're here. You know what? You gotta make sure they cover the outside portion of the plate, because if you're a good pitcher and he stands back here and you spot pitches, he's not gonna touch you. That is just simple baseball model. We gotta stay here and we gotta make sure we hit that outside pitch. So RO is outside. If I stand traditionally, it's a foot off the line, there's no way in hell I'm gonna hit you. Right? I gotta saddle up. You know what saddle up is? The plate is the horse's back, and I'm saddling up the plate. You understand that? Okay, good. So if I'm saddling up here, and I gotta hit the outside pitch, I'm gonna hit it with this bat every single time because I'm close, right? What happens when we put it inside, and I'm saddling up? Can I hit that? Yeah, I'm gonna do it. You're gonna take your hands inside. Every single time. Did I move my feet? No. Right? So, this is an important tool. It used to be about $100. Now you can get it for $40. If you do this with your kids, you will see massive improvement. Coaches just don't like using it because they don't understand it. You know, they give the kids a short bat, they go, hey, that's for one hand. Big dummies. This is a two-hand short bat. Right? You got, hitters like Trout, Bryce Harper, all the elite hitters training with that so that they can get their hands and feet. The saddling up, okay, it's a lot of talk, but you need to understand what you're doing, right? It's kind of like pooping. You poop, you gotta wipe your butt, right? It's automatic. I take my stance because I need to hit the ball. It works hand in hand. You understand? Okay, so we're gonna saddle up and we're gonna swing 20 more. And we're gonna try and finish our swing each time and try and get it to the white dot each time. And the only reason we need to get it to the white dot is because that's the perfect launch angle. If we're hitting 9 out of 10 times into the white dot, then we get all those line drives. 82% of all line drives are base hits, right? Who's your best major league player?
Who's your favorite?
Who? Why? Cause what? Come on, tell me why. Why you like him? He's a good hitter. He's pretty darn good. He's strong, right? What about you? Oh, you're garbage. You just don't. You don't follow
him. I like him because he's a good fielder.
What's his fielding percentage?
He has a few errors.
He's a pro. He's a pro. You know who's the best all around? These two know, maybe even more. You know who's the best major league player from probably 3-4 years ago until he retires? Mike Trout. You know why? Because he trains 24/7. You see him hit the ball. Total balance. Yeah. Sometimes his hands are out front, total core, torque. I mean, not fancy, right? He doesn't mouth off. He's humble. And he's got the best score, I mean, from 80 years ago. You know, that's amazing, but it's hard work. So you two are gonna get on the tee. Hey, Cuz, grab the other short back.
The same bucket?
Yeah, should be in there. Then you're gonna grab the short back, both of you. And you're gonna try and swing with two hands. So you go back to your tee. Not going two hands, so you understand. The two hands is to restrict his upper body on his movement. Okay. Good. Gotta go two hands, hold the nose. Okay, let's go with the positions. Good. If I'm already sitting on this right here, okay, I'm covering the plate, nothing will get by me. Okay, we're restricting your movement with this. All you need to do is barrel up every time. Low and barrel up. But hold you down. Low and barrel up. And hold you down. Okay? Open up your feet a little bit so you got a better base. Go down. So where'd that ball go? Up high. Okay, move that shoulder to the ball. Okay, now turn your back to it. So you turn your back to it. You got to do this. Right? And see how high up your hand is? You just got to drop that on your feet. So you can get that. Good.
You know why it's good? Because your body weight's here. Balance that body weight first, hand position is second. Your hand position, I'm not looking at, but you're rolling off this way. You just gotta get your foot down on your stride. Good. Open up here, right? What is this called right here? What shape? Triangle, you bet. Ankle to manas, right? One big triangle. The tighter my triangle, the more balance I get every single swing. Every single swing, okay? You're coming off your triangle with your front foot and your back foot. Keep your ankles down.
Keep that left foot.
Ankle to ankle. To what?
Enough. He's been trying to switch it.
More balance you get, the more power you get. Train. Go. Swing. Left side. Up. Good chance. Move it to the back side. I think you should keep doing it and never stop. Is that good?
The left?
No bullshit. What's up?
Okay.
I will show you five of my 12-year-old girls that they were big rollers with their right hands. They were right-handed players. They threw right, they batted right, but they rolled over so much that I switched them to left because now their right hand is the pull hand. Their strong hand is the pull hand. And they're all that. 2 years in, they don't hit right now. And I have a short bat. Can I reach the outside pitch? It's gonna be a tough shot, right? So it's always about saddling up. It's always about saddling up and make sure we can cover the entire surface of the plate. Okay, because if we can, for your age, you gotta get even closer. See, you can move as close as you want as long as you don't step out of the box. And if the umpire tells you, scoot back in, you can tell I'm not out of the box. So you see my toes? I'm okay. Alright, right at the edge. Can I reach that now? Yes. Can I reach that now? A little bit. Alright. So that's saddling up. You gotta figure out where it's at. Dad will make sure you saddle up. Because by the time you get to his age, they're gonna tap outside all day long and they throw them here. Can I reach the ball? Nope. Strike out, swing in there, strike out. Okay? So we gotta make sure we're here. And we gotta make sure when we're swinging that our body weight is here. Here. Not here. Look at my shoulders. Two different positions, right? Hold your armpit, low, and swing, okay? The rubber mallet is good because it pisses everybody off. Because you only got one place to hit the ball. So the kids get really pissed off. It serves the same purpose. That's why we work these two together. We work those together, all right? So we gotta hold our armpit so we can feel our bodies come across. And we gotta just barrel up. It's better to hit it straight or oppo instead of pulling. Because if we're pulling, then our hand position. See my hand position? Okay? It's better to hit a line drive oppo than a roller to short. Okay. So you start here, you come across. You guys thought we was gonna do some front toss today, huh? Maybe we'll do something. You need to drop them off every day. I don't know what to tell you.
You have a rubber belt?
What?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have one of those.
See, kids just ain't so good. That's amazing. Honestly, you should already start a YouTube account. I'm dead serious. I'm dead serious.
He's got an Instagram.
Coaches will go and look.
Really?
Oh, you bet. You can pull up my name. You can see all the athletes that started a YouTube account years ago.
Wow.
Because when college coaches are interested, if they pull up hitting, my name or one of the athletes' name, those videos will come up.
Oh, nice.
YouTube's amazing.
Hey, make sure I get some good
pictures. Yeah.
One of my girls got a full ride.
Wow.
To college, offer YouTube account.
Have you been?
No, my own kids, I got two.
Oh, okay.
But my personal kids, I have probably seven.
Oh, wow.
Personal, like, I get them from when they're 4 years old or younger,
yeah.
Or a little older,
yeah.
And they end up going through college or both.
Wow.
I consider them my children.
Yeah, of course.
Good job. Very, very good.
Don't hit me, Bubba.
Good luck. This mat shows you what to do and how to do it. You gotta make sure that you're saddling up the plate. Like the guy.
That's the first time I see it.
That boy.
Yeah.
That boy. Put the bat on the ball right now. Let me see your hand position. Put the bat on the ball. Okay, look. So, we gotta back up just a little bit this way. Put your hands. We gotta back up so that we can move this way. You see how your palm fits the bat? Hitting the ball, not hitting the ball, right? Squeeze the bat. That's where your hands are, that's where your elbows are here. So watch, I'm gonna turn your hand back, okay? And your elbow can drop so you can finish it. You understand that? Short bats, you don't even have at it. Two of my kids, the girl on the window right behind you, she loved this so much she had two of each. She's on the women's USA team.
Yeah.
The rubber mallet and the black short bat, she does not stop at all. Now, she could be watching TV, sitting on a bucket, and she'd be doing her one hand drills. Hey, so you think you're good? You have to say yes, you have to be confident. You know what I mean? Because you know when I did recruiting, when I walked up to an athlete, say I wanted to, your dad was one of the marquee players that I was recruiting. If I walked up to him and I said, hey, are you good? And he kind of just nodded and said, like you. Then he shows me no confidence. You need to be confident. When somebody asked you that, you said, yes, I am. Okay? You need to understand where you can go, and I want to help you and advise your parents how to do it, because I scouted in the major leagues. Yeah? He just smiled at me.
right?
Yeah.
Looks pretty comfortable.
As hard as you can. It's called the power drill. Okay? I want to see if the last 45 minutes, if you remembered your feet and your hand position. So now all you gotta think about is swinging the bat as hard as you can. Can you do that? Most kids can't, even the college ones. They'll swing three hard, then they stop. They'll swing one hard, then they stop. I need 5 minutes of hard swings. Can you do that? 5 minutes. Can you do that for 5 minutes? Okay, you guys gotta help watch too. Because most of the time, 9 out of 10 kids, they stop swinging hard. So you're gonna swing three on this side, and you're gonna come swing three on this side, then go back there and three and three, okay? All right. Good. What is this drill called?
Joe.
At the end of his workouts at home, have him do the power drill for 5 minutes. And then once he gets the groove, then increase it to 10. So this drill helps them to think about swinging hard every single time, and it's a lot of core. They don't understand. It's kind of like boxing. A lot of core, same thing. Good swing. One more, we're right. I have a 6-year-old that plays at EU. Legit. Legit kid. His cousin is Joey Gallo from Texas.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah?
And last one. And this kid is unreal. He hit, you know how they have the machine?
Yeah.
The swing? He hit the coaches and the swing 9 times so far this season. I drive. Unreal, this kid. His balance. That does what I told you guys to get the short bats, same exact format and structure. He has a kick, do it twice a day at home. And he legitimately hits the line drives to the fence.
You know how small that fence is? I think it's like 150, 175. On the fly. It's amazing. I keep all his video because I told Dad the same thing I'm telling you, like your husband. Those are the kids that can go further quicker than anybody else because they're putting in that extra time with understanding. 100%.
Get your legs wider.
Open up a little bit, the triangle. Remember towards the triangle? Here you go. Straight back up. Straight back and up. Okay, so stop. Okay. Where do you feel the stress? Shoulder? Pecs? Stomach? Are you got ticklish? No?
He's ticklish.
Oh, I can tell. I've seen his face. He's already got that. We're just trying to enhance that hand position and the feet. That's a 6 pound, that's a 10 pound. Core and upper body strength. So when you look at females, right, they're smaller up above, but they can be just as big as you and I. And they just got to get that work.
Hands together.
Hey, Bob. And then you'll see the production in the end. So when they're done, I'm gonna have you guys look at Eli right in this. How old are you today?